The following webinar is a demonstration on how to navigate Health Passport. Health Passport is a patient-centered, internet-based health record. It makes a foster child's information available to authorized providers and medical stakeholders, such as medical consenters and caseworkers. The data in Health Passport is not a person's complete medical record, but it does contain information on patient demographics, such as doctor visits for which claims have been submitted, allergies, lab test results, immunizations, and filled medications. There are also electronic Texas health steps, dental, and behavioral health forms available through Health Passport. The user agreement and disclaimer will display every time the user logs into Health Passport. Scroll down to review the user agreement and disclaimer. Click I have read and agree to these terms to continue. To search for a member, enter the member's first and last name, followed by the Medicaid ID, Social Security number, or DFPS ID in the respective fields. Only the first few letters of the member's first and last name are needed to search. Click Go to start the search. Search results will display below the search bar. Every member currently eligible for foster care can be searched in Health Passport to view their health record online. The health plan will need to be contacted to obtain any information related to members who were once enrolled in foster care but are not currently eligible. Contact information will be given at the end of this presentation. Click the member's name to open the health record. Every member's health record will contain 10 modules. These modules encompass a range of information and can be accessed using the navigation buttons to the left. A module is one section of information found within the member's health record and will be a term used throughout this presentation. The face sheet is the first module. It provides an easy-to-read summary of the member's health record, focusing on key information that's critical for providers at the point of care. Important member demographic information is displayed, as well as indicating if the member is IDD and if they have any care gaps. The face sheet will also show the date the 3-day exam was completed, the most recent Texas Health Steps exam, as well as the last CANS completion date. Information also includes the last dental visit date, most common diagnoses and procedures, active allergies, and active medications. The top 5 diagnoses and procedures are those that are most prevalent in the member's record. Active medications are those that have been prescribed in the past 90 days. One of the new features for the face sheet is the continuity of care document indicated by the CCD export option. By clicking the CCD export button, a file will download to your computer. The file contains all of the information in the member's health record in a format designed to be uploaded into an electronic medical record, or EMR system. The CCD export feature allows users to incorporate the data from Health Passport into their clinical system. If you need to search for a new member, click Member Search. You will also have the option to print. To print a record, click on Print All in the upper right corner. Select a date range and click Go. The record will display in PDF form and be made available to print. To print a select module, click on the Print button below the Print All link. The record will again display in PDF form and be made available to print. The Contacts module conveniently lists the foster child's PCP, medical consenter or consenters, caregiver, caseworker, and service coordinator all in one place. Keep in mind that a listed caregiver is not always a medical consenter. A contact must be listed as a medical consenter in order to make medical decisions and, therefore, may appear twice on this list. Once as a caregiver and once as a medical consenter. Refer to the list to ensure the appropriate individual is contacted concerning member care. The Allergies module contains all allergies for a member that have been entered by providers. Once an allergy is charted, it is instantly checked for interactions against the medication history. Interactions with medications are indicated by the red M symbol to the left of the allergy substance. An allergy with a strikethrough indicates either a resolved or canceled status. Resolved allergies are those the member no longer experiences. Canceled allergies are those that may have been mistakenly entered into the health record. The allergy substance can be clicked to view more information, including the date of the first occurrence, provider comments, and allergy history. Existing allergies can also be modified by selecting Modify. Make changes where necessary and click Update to save the changes. Allergies can also be added to the member's health record using the Add Allergy tab. Type the name of the allergen into the search box and click Go. Click the allergen name that best fits the substance causing the member's allergic reaction. The Add Free Text allergen box can be used to enter an allergen that isn't found using the allergen search. Complete the remaining detail fields and click Add to enter the allergy into the foster child's health record. The Assessments module contains Texas Health Steps, Dental, Child-Adolescent Needs and Strengths, and Behavioral Health forms. You can filter the data by date, select a date from the drop-down menu, or enter in a from and to date to filter viewable data by date. The assessment name and submit date are viewable and categorized by form type. The Expand All and Collapse All buttons reveal and hide all forms for all categories. Specific categories of forms can be expanded and collapsed by clicking on each category header. This may be an ideal option for those members with a longer history of forms. The details and contents of a form can be viewed by clicking the specific assessment name. A new window will open that contains the respective assessment's details. Texas Health Steps, Behavioral Health, and Dental forms can be entered online using the Submit Forms tab. Use the same Expand and Collapse buttons to find the correct form template. Select a form template by clicking on the form title. Descriptions of each form template are provided to the right of the form title. Enter the necessary information and click Submit when the form is complete. Forms will appear in the member's health record 24 hours after they have been submitted online. Please note that a form in progress cannot be saved. Forms must be completed from start to finish in one sitting to avoid losing any information entered. Forms may also be faxed or mailed. Printable versions of all forms can be accessed from the PDF button. A fax number and mailing address can be found on the Superior Health Plan website. The Growth Chart module is designed for providers to record height, weight, length, and head circumference to track the growth of infants and children. BMI is automatically calculated based on measurements entered. The Growth Chart will also indicate the member's percentile within the given measurement. A star next to a value indicates there is a comment associated with the entry. Comments and other details can be viewed by clicking on the date of a given Growth Chart entry. Health Passport will also calculate the percentiles associated with the Growth Chart measurements in the PCTL column. Users also have the option to review the data in graphic format by clicking View as Chart. Growth charts can be downloaded and saved as PDF or printed using the buttons on the top right. Growth chart entries can be canceled in the event there is an error or duplicate entry. Select the entry to cancel from the growth chart by checking the box in the Select Cancel column. Choose the reason for removing the respective entry and click Cancel. A strikethrough will appear and the respective measurement will be grayed out to indicate it is no longer a valid entry. Use the Add Growth Chart tab to enter in new growth chart measurements. Enter each value and click Add. The new entry will appear at the top of the growth chart history. The Immunizations module provides a list of immunizations the foster child has received that have been reported to ImTRAC, the Texas Immunization Registry. Immunizations can be sorted by the vaccine or the date administered by clicking on the column titles to change the view. Additional pages of immunizations can be viewed by clicking Next, Last, or the respective page number at the bottom of the module. The Schedule tab houses links to the child, adolescent, adult, and catch-up immunization schedules provided by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the CDC. The Care Gaps tab lists any gaps in care the member has, including missing immunizations. The Labs module contains lab results for the member. Labs can be filtered by category using the Filter Category drop-down menu. A star next to a value indicates there is a comment associated. Details of each lab can be viewed by clicking on the date of a given lab. Additional pages of labs can be viewed by clicking Next, Last, or the respective page number at the bottom of the module. The Medication History module provides a summary of medication prescriptions that have been filled and picked up. Medication to medication and allergy to medication interactions are indicated to the left with varying symbols. A legend to interpret these symbols is provided just above the medication history. Details about each interaction can be viewed by clicking on the medication interaction symbol to the left of a given medication. Click on prescriber and pharmacy names to view contact information. A medication's prescription history and reference documents can be obtained by clicking the medication name. Patient history displays visit details collected from claims data for all services rendered, regardless of whether the claim paid or denied. Information for each visit can be viewed by clicking on the date in the first column to the left. Patient history can be sorted by date, visit type, billing entity, and source by clicking the respective column header at the top. You can also review the history by both the diagnosis and procedure using the tabs at the top of the module. This information can also be sorted by date, diagnosis, diagnosis code, billing entity, and source by clicking the respective column header at the top. To view additional information related to the diagnosis or description, click on the date column in the respective tab. In the filter category dropdown, you will have the option to choose all patient history or psychiatric admissions. The same options for sorting apply to this category as well. Claims data is all services rendered, whether paid or denied. Users should not use this module as a tool for claims payments. Providers have 95 days to bill, and the health plan has 30 days to process before claims will load to Health Passport. Please keep this in mind when looking for visits in the application. In the appointments module, users are going to be able to add, modify, or cancel their own appointment entries. To add an appointment, click Add Appointment, enter the date, time, and duration, and click Add. This completes the Health Passport demonstration. For more information, please visit our website at superiorhealthplan.com. For support, email txpassportadmin@centene.com or call 866-714-7996.